Before the 16th century, clocks were horrible. Typically, there was one large mechanical clock in the center of any town which would be reset daily, but by the end of the day, these would be off by as much as 20 minutes. Time was but a rough estimate, but nobody really had a problem with it since there was no expectation of accuracy. At the time, there was no real need for accurate clocks in daily life. The need for more accurate clocks came about when explorers started to voyage across the world by sea. The best way for ships to calculate their locations was to have two clocks, one with the time of the ship's origin and one with the current time, as calculated by a sundial. With every 4 minutes of difference between the two times, you would know that you had traveled about 68 miles, or 1 degree of longitude. The problem with this method was with the accuracy of the clocks. Much like the clocks in town centers, the origin clocks were off by up to 20 minutes by the end of one day, so this method was useless after a few days of travel. This stifled exploration, so governments around the world offered prizes equivalent to millions of dollars to anyone who could design an accurate clock. That's where Galileo comes into play. Legend has it that in 1583, a 19-year-old Galileo was bored while attending prayers at the Duomo of Pisa, so he started watching the hanging lamps up above. He noticed that, as they swung back and forth, the lamps always took the exact same amount of time to complete one swing. No matter if they swung 1 foot or 1 inch, the swing would always take the exact same amount of time. 58 years later, this property was used to make a pendulum clock. Properly weighted, a pendulum could be designed to swing once per second, and the clocks would use this swinging weight to keep time. This clock was amazingly accurate. A week after being set, it would only be off by as much as a minute. 100 years after its invention, the pendulum clock was in every house. Many argue that, without this invention, the Industrial Revolution would not have been possible. You could now tell someone to meet you at an exact time, and they would actually be there at that time. Ships could now use these accurate clocks for accurate navigation, and this meant that it was no longer risky to send ships regularly to buy and sell goods across the world. Accurate time also changed the way people worked. Before the pendulum clock, people only worked for results. By the end of the day, they were paid for how much they made instead of how much they worked. With the clock, workers worked for an amount of time and they were paid by the hour. With a new production boom, manufacturers demanded a method of fast and cheap shipping, and so the railroad was born, but this introduced a new problem. Time was still dictated by the sun. Each town would calculate the local time based upon the location of the sun in the sky, but this meant that from one town to the next, the time would be different. In one town, it could be 8:10, and in the next town over, it would be 8:15. Both times were correct for the two locations, so this didn't really cause any problems since it would take hours to get to that next town over. Across the United States, there were thousands of different local times. However, with the newly invented railroad, people could get from one town to the next quickly, but nobody knew when trains really left since everyone used a different time. The railroad might use one time, while the origin town would use another, and the destination town would use a completely different one. Britain solved this problem by creating a standardized time, Greenwich Mean Time, and transmitting that time across the country by telegraph. The US decided that, with its huge size, a standard time zone would not work, so 4 different time zones were mapped out. Much like Britain, the standard time would be transmitted across the country by telegraph. The implementation of this new time zone, however, created one of the stranger days in human history. The new Eastern time zone ran 4 minutes behind the time that New York had been using, so on Sunday, November 18th, 1883, the clock struck noon, then 4 minutes later, the clock struck noon again as the new time standard was implemented. The next great innovation in timekeeping came towards the beginning of the 20th century. Pierre and Jacques Curie, two French physicists, noticed that when electricity was applied to quartz, it vibrates at an incredibly stable rate. Knowing that quartz vibrates 32,768 times a second, clockmakers used this crystal to make incredibly accurate clocks. These quartz clocks were able to go a month only losing or gaining 15 seconds. Just as the pendulum clock allowed for the Industrial Revolution, the quartz clock allowed for the Technological Revolution. Without quartz clocks, modern computers would have been impossible. An accurate internal clock is needed to coordinate all the different microprocessors. With these new accurate clocks, however, people also began to notice that Earth's rotation wasn't all that regular. it deviated by a few seconds here and there. In the 1950s, the first super accurate atomic clocks were built, measuring time based upon the decay of atomic elements, and this allowed an international conference of weight and measures to change what time was in 1967. They decided that a day was no longer one rotation of the Earth. A day was now 86,400 atomic seconds. Since the time it takes for Earth to rotate is not exactly 86,400 atomic seconds, we make up for this by having leap days and leap seconds every once in a while. The atomic clock also allowed for nanosecond accuracy, and this is actually pretty important for many modern technologies, most notably the GPS. GPS works by asking three different satellites the time based upon their onboard atomic clocks. When the answer comes back, each time will be slightly different on a nanosecond level due to the satellites being at different distances and the request for the time going out at only the speed of light. So the GPS, knowing the location of the satellites based upon their extremely predictable orbits, can figure out where it is. So that's how time developed. Hopefully you can now see how the human conception of time was essential for the development of our modern world and can still be called one of humanity's greatest inventions. Today, we're going to talk about space law. So back in ye olde days, property owners had the rights to their land going up forever and ever in perpetuity. But then the airplane came around and smart people realized that you couldn't just go around asking every property owner for permission to fly through their airspace.